seat.
Well, Mrs. Savage, I believe I have everything. Here's your $85 hat. I told you you'd need it again.
My beautiful and foolish hat.
You know, I believe you've been wearing it backwards.
You know, I have. It's good to be straightened out.
Where did everybody go?
They gave me going away presents and then refused to say goodbye.
I bet I can guess what they gave you.
No, you can't. Mrs. Patty gave me an eye with which to see myself. Florence, a grain of salt to take with what I see.
That's good. And fairy?
A memory of loveliness.
I'm afraid to most people, she wouldn't seem a lovely girl.
She wears her plainness with great beauty.
And Jeff?
The Book of Job.
Nothing from Hannibal?
I'd say he gave me an appreciation of music I never had before.
Well, I have a little gift for you, too.
You behave yourself.
It isn't much.
It better not be. My bonds.
Except for a corner of one that I had to burn with the newspapers to make it look convincing.
Where did you find them?
I didn't. I stole them when the lights went out.
Why?
I'm not sure.
Don't tell me you're a kleptomaniac.
No, it was too quick to think. What bothers me is I toyed with the idea of keeping them.
That's a normal human impulse. What stopped you?
What Jeff might think.
You really should get away from here, dear. That kind of thinking isn't good for you.
Oh, but you knew Jeff was my husband, didn't you?
I certainly did not.
He is, and I want to be here when he recovers. The only reason I didn't keep those bonds is I want to do everything for him myself. Pure selfishness. Surely you can understand that.
The only thing I don't understand is how I ever could have felt so sorry for myself. Isn't there something about, there's no fool like a you-know-what?
There is, but I don't think it applies to you.
Does anyone else know about these?
I told Dr. Emmett.
Well, whether you want it or not, you're both going to be hearing from my memorial fund.
I talked with the medical examiner.
Yes?
The station wagon is waiting outside, ready to take you whenever you want to go.
Will you take Mrs. Savage's bag to the car, please?
Goodbye, Mrs. Savage. It's been a pleasure.
I have a few more papers for you to sign, then you're free to leave.
I must be out of my mind. I don't want to go.
You mean you prefer to leave tomorrow?
I don't think I want to leave at all.
Why do you want to stay?
Suddenly, I'm weary. I would like to rest. I would like to be relieved of decision. I would like to be protected against uncertainty and accident. I would like to close my eyes at night and know that there are walls around me to guard my sleep.
But the peace you find here is like, it's like that of the moon, reflected on a dark lake. Strike the surface and you destroy it. Is that the kind of peace you want?
I want what everyone wants, to want nothing. These people have found contentment.
How do you know?
Silly hat.
How do you know?
I have eyes to see.
So is Jeffrey, but he only sees what he wants to see. An excuse for not facing the future. Does Florence see her child was taken from her? Does Fairy see what the mirror should tell her? No, they've all found comfort in an eggshell world where you don't belong. For you see yourself clearly, I'm sure.
Then where do I belong?
In the world in which you can best serve. The impulse to live your life with courage was right. Go ahead with your memorial fund. And don't be betrayed by the illusion of contentment. The door is open for you. Make your peace with loneliness.
Wait! Mrs. Savage, I'm glad you're still here. I thought of something I could give you.
Oh, Hannibal, not your violin.
Oh, no. You couldn't play it. But I can give you a song that you can take wherever you go. Here's your song.
Oh,
It was a great show. My directorial debut at Covenant. And best of all, the cast did well. And it's over. So I can sleep now.
Nothing about the stage crew.
Stage crew also was great. They carried furniture with great ease. And I want them back for every show. Because really, I literally could not have done the show without them. I would have had to schlep all the furniture myself. And no one wants to see that. Actually, everyone wants to see that, but I don't want to do that, is how it goes. So there you are. Those are some thoughts, some words of wisdom. I'll be waking up around Tuesday at 2 o'clock. So I'll see you then.
I'm very impressed with all of the students, and even with the students yet. Everybody was hilarious. Brooke was quite the character, as well as, well, okay, all of them. I was very impressed with Marianne memorizing the 397 lines, and impressed with the statistician and the various math jokes. And I'm disappointed that Carissa hates friction among the other things that she hates, but she was fabulous. Outstanding job. And to the entire cast, my hats off. I'm not wearing a hat. So.